Hello friends, today I'm gonna do a review, not a kind of review, but my personal experience after 2 months of owning the RC390. Guys, let me start. I have been with this bike for about 70 days. That means almost more than 2 months. And I am riding this bike regularly. I think daily I used to ride my bike. I didn't face any serious problem till date. I have just visited the service station once. Yeah, I think once, only once, not twice. First I visited for the first service, which I need to be done after. I got my first service done at around 750 kilometers. I would recommend you guys to also get your bike serviced at 750 kilometers, because it's the run-in period, so you should get your bike serviced 750 kilometers, and you should not ride your bike too fast. I mean, the engine speed should not be too fast. You can go in 6th gear up to 90 speed, 90-100 speed. So guys, and one more time, I visited the KTM service center because my first gear, when I was engaging the first gear, I was hearing a sound, a clunk sound, but the gear was not getting engaged. For after 5 to 10 tries, I got the first gear engaged, and I went to the KTM service center, and the guys told me that it might be due to the lever was too low, adjusted too low. So this is adjustable gear. From here you can adjust the gear where the position of the gear should be. So he lifted it little bit up, and after that I'd never faced any problem. And little bit problem are there in this bike, like vibration problem, mainly this part, this RMV, this has some vibration only at certain RPM, not at every RPM. The guy at the service center were very helpful. They didn't charge me any money, they did this for free. And I also got this seat leveled like this. This was not in level. That's it. So guys, this many of the owners faced the problem of leaking shock absorbers, but I till date I am not experiencing any of the problem. And some of them had to get the radiator fan replaced, like the OGF. If you follow OGF, you must have heard that he also has to get his radiator fan replaced or repaired. Guys, that is not the problem with every RC. This bike has a good build quality, not bit good, but at least average build quality. And guys, if your luck wins, you can get a very good bike. Trust me, bike. Trust me guys, you can get a very good bike, because like the Everyday India told me that he never faced any serious problem till date, never ever. And I also never faced any problem, just minor problems I faced, which I have described, and nothing serious I have ever faced. So guys, it might be due to luck or by anything else, but you will not face any major problem with this bike. Guys, if you are a beginner, I would not recommend you this bike, because it has a mammoth amount of torque and a very high power engine, so you might risk your life. So guys, don't go for this. Go for some 200cc bike or 150cc bike to get expert on riding. Don't go for 390 if you are a beginner. And if you have confidence and you think you can, you have ridden some other bike and you can handle the power of this bike, then you may go for it. But I would not strongly recommend. And guys, this can easily go in first gear up to 58 km per hour. And its top speed is around 177 km per hour. And that is practical. You can go till 177. And guys, these bikes are kind of super sports. So don't expect that it will serve you as like bullet or something like that. You can go in off-roading or like that. See the ground clearance, it's very less even at floor surface. So guys, you will hit the ground any odd day, so don't get panic that you have broken your bike, you have got scratched. It's a minor thing. Every RC owner has that problem, so that's not a big deal. If your bike get touched from below, that should not be a problem. You can fit some cardboard or something if you don't want scratches on that, but it will increase the problem of touching the ground more. The ground clearance will decrease. In the 2016 model, the ground clearance is increased. So guys, you don't have to worry much, but it will hit the ground some odd day. Some of the guys I heard that they said that this bike is not comfortable. Guys, I would explain the whole scenario. What happened is, the guys have generally ridden a Bullet or Splendor or Pulsar which have an upright position, which doesn't pain in short rides, but in long term use, like if you're riding a Bullet or a Duke for a long, like 1 year or so, you will develop a serious back problem because it hits from below. And in this, you will get a minor pain, but you will not get a serious pain because this has a tilt. You have to be in an aggressive position like this, so you won't have that, what you call it, back pain. You will have a back pain, not a back pain, I think the shoulder and wrist pain you will have, but little bit of back pain, but that's not a serious problem. You will not get a serious attack on your disc plate, your rib, on your bone. So guys, this is a myth that this bike is not comfortable. If you ride it for around 1 month or 1.5 month, you will get used to it and you can go miles and miles. Some of them have done Ladakh from Bangalore. That is around 2500 to 3000 kilometers. I mean, they can do it, then you can also do it. You will get habitual to this bike. You will feel lovely on this bike. You will not face any kind of problem once you got habitual to this bike. So guys, trust me, there is not even any comfort problem in this bike. I have got this seat cover with foam so that I don't get pain much, and this handle grips. So you can also get it and it will work for perfectly fine. And guys, you will not face any pain problem once you have ridden for around 1500 kilometers or 1.5 months. You will get habitual to it. And guys, I have done around 240 kilometers on this bike without any stop. Just I stopped after 220 kilometers for refilling. When I hit the reserve at around 200 kilometers, that was in the running in period only, so I didn't go too fast. It took me around 3 hours to ride 200 kilometers. And guys, I was completely okay with it and didn't face any serious problem. So I think you can go on touring on this bike, but you can't do off-roading. And guys, I have heard that some of the RCs have stalled because of heat problems. Guys, in 2016 model, you will never ever face this kind of problem. I have done the 200 km in Delhi, in which the bumper to bumper traffic was there. And in the month of, I think, July or August, when I just after I bought it, I on the next day or day after next day, I went for a long ride, and it was bumper to bumper traffic. It was a highway. I never ever got stalled. My bike never got stalled, and I was having a very good time on my bike. So there is no need to worry of if you think that bike will get heat problem. There is no heat problem in this bike. Yeah, you will feel the heat, but the bike will never stall, and you can the bike ECU will always get the heat in control. The fan will run and you will not get heat problem, but you might feel the heat in bumper to bumper traffic. The guys, the bike is awesome. The looks are awesome. The headlamps, it will make, as I have already mentioned in the previous video, the looks are awesome. It will make you a celebrity within minutes. So guys, do go for it. That's my honest review. Not a review, my experience with my RC. You can also go for it. And guys, one thing I want to mention, the brakes. With Mazlers and the brakes, you get awesome stopping power. When you hit the brake, this bike can go to from 100 to 0 in just 10 to 15 meters. I think that's awesome, guys. If the road is okay, you will get in 100 to 0 speed in just 10 meters. So guys, thank you for watching. That's my honest experience. Do share, subscribe to my channel and comment on my video. Thank you guys. Thank you.